All right, 2K fans, your boy Jukane the Boss, and you already know that E3 is right around the corner. And by the name of the title, you can tell that we're going to talk about speculation of whether or not NBA 2K20 will be unveiled at E3. And the answer is a possible yes. Now, I've been scouring the internet, looking for all the articles, looking at all the different takes, looking at all the different looks, and coming up with a lot of my own theories based on why there's a chance we actually see NBA 2K20 unveiled at E3. So first of all, let's look at E3 and who's going to be there, who's not going to be there. So we know that Take-Two usually have a presence on the showroom floor, but this year it says that they're opening up and having an even bigger presence on the an expanded presence at E3. So there's an article on the Fly talking about how Take-Two says company will have an expanded presence at E3. Now, Take-Two, parent company of 2K, also parent company of Rockstar Games. They're expected to have, of course, some Red Dead Online on the floor, or some more Red Dead news on the floor. Of course, we're gonna possibly get a reveal. I highly doubt it, though. They're expecting that there's a possible reveal of GTA 6 or Bully 2, but I don't think, well, that's not from The Fly, that's from another article I was reading, but I don't think that we'll see either of those games get showcased, because right now GTA 5 is still doing well and Red Dead Online just came out of beta. So they wouldn't put all their eggs in a new basket and just completely abandon this product and this project after they finally got it out of beta. So I highly doubt we're going to see that. But expanding a presence could mean a number of things. I mean, we know that we're going to see some Borderlands 3. We know that they got a couple of independent IPs. We know they're going to most likely spend a little time showcasing any new Civilization expansions, maybe even touch up on some WWE 2K. But one of their biggest things is that NBA 2K needs to be hit. It needs to be successful. It creates a part of their revenue. So Take-Two wants to expand their reach. They want to expand their presence. I really feel that they're going to lead with the NBA 2K20 being on the showroom floor. Even go as far as to say NBA 2K20 could be a highlight game at the Xbox press event. Now, why the Xbox press event? And that's because when you look at the current press events, the only one of the major consoles that won't be directly at E3 is Sony. Now, Nintendo does their Nintendo Direct usually leading up to E3, and they usually do their Nintendo Direct during E3. So that way they usually do have games on the floor that they showcase. But Sony is skipping E3 altogether. Now, I'm not sure if that means that they're not going to do anything E3 related, but I know that they won't have a presence there. Now they have been dropping videos, dropping gems directly to the community through their own streams, where they talked about games coming out and this, that, and the other. Trying to most likely save some costs, because they kind of did really spend a lot of money on E3 last year, and as much money as they made, it really didn't warrant that kind of budget that they spent for that kind of presence that really didn't take off the way that they wanted it to. So that could mean that if NBA 2K is going to be showcased on any floor, when it comes down to press events, the best option would be Xbox. Now, why would they go Xbox? It's not to say Xbox better than PS, all that BS, none of that. You know, first of all, y'all know I'm team Xbox all the way, but Xbox being as they'll be the only company there, like locally there, one of the best things about showcasing on that floor is there's speculation that Xbox might unveil their next gen consoles on the floor as well. And if that is the case, one of the premium ways to kind of like drive traffic or get more members is to try to grab members from a specific community. Okay, so instead of showing something like what Fortnite would look like on next gen, instead, because you know they'll decide to go with a game that could use a really big benefit from graphical purity, graphical improvement, gameplay improvement, things like that, all of the back end stuff that can be dealt with because of cloud gaming. Now, you know, there's also talk that they're gonna be unveiling the X Cloud gaming, or talking more about it at E3, but because there's not a big list of games that Xbox are talking about, and they, you know, jumped on some games in the past that have turned out to be failures, so why not invest some time and resources in trying to bring in a game that is a success, regardless of all about ups and downs about it, the game's a success. So what else would that mean? I mean, how else would they go about that? And does that mean that there's a benefit of playing on Xbox? No, it just means that if you want to make sure all eyes are on you, the Xbox briefing is on Sunday, June 9th, if I'm correct, June 8th or June 9th. And it's at like 4 p.m. Eastern time. You can always look it up at your local time, but it's because it's on Sunday, because most people won't have to go anywhere, it's probably the best time. And I think if I'm correct, well, we got playoff games going on around that time. So it'd be the perfect time to unveil, because people will be already geared up and at their TVs, you know? So I think that there's a big, big chance. Probably, to me, I'm willing to say about 75% chance that 2K shows up and shows off NBA 2K20. Another reason, probably one of the biggest reasons is because recently in the past couple of weeks, a couple of the devs for 2K were recently posting, and I think LD2K or Mike Wang posted on Twitter where they said the calm before the storm. Now, we already know we usually expect 2K information to start dropping at the end of July, beginning of August. So why the calm before the storm if there's a whole 2 months in between that text? Now, some people are speculating that they're talking about the fact that they're starting to dive into the creation of the process. No, not really. They've been creating the game for forever already. What that could most likely means is that they're going into post and starting to touch it up and everything like that. So there could be a chance that they have a build of the game that they're going to showcase on the E3 floor. There's a build of the game that they're going to demo on probably the Xbox stage or even at Take-Two's booth. So Take-Two, now the reason why it's more prominent that it would most likely be on the Xbox stage is because you know for a fact that all eyes are going to be on it. Xbox, would want to invest in this mainly because they took an L in the console wars this time around, and because we're getting ready for the next wave of systems. Sony has already unveiled what the specs of theirs are. One of the best ways that you can unveil the specs is showcasing a game that a lot of people play, and it is one of the bigger games that are played. Whether casually or competitive, and there's so much money already being invested into the game itself, so why not take it that step further? And with the backing of the NBA, it does kind of help to know that you can kind of get people to put their eyes on your stage that would normally not look at your stage. But it's E3. Everybody's want to see everything from everyone at E3. I know I've been kind of just rambling a little bit, but I want y'all you can go online, look it up, and just type in Take-Two E3. And you'll see articles talking about Take-Two's expanded presence. And when you dive into Xbox's E3 presence and what they plan on showcasing, the article really is talking about how Xbox hasn't really revealed any games that they're going to talk about. And this is not the time where they cannot talk about games. Okay, like, we know that the console generation is winding down. They just unveiled their newest console, well, their newest member of the Xbox family. Man, we gotta swear, this family like 15 boxes deep. Good God, we be deep. Yeah, so they've unveiled their new Xbox, and now when you look at the unveiling of that and it's an all digital Xbox, you kind of want to make sure that you're supporting that with, oh, there's reasons to, I got to get me an Xbox. Now, like I said, I would highly doubt that 2K would ever take the route of going exclusive with one console over the next. But I do believe that if there's a nice little way to unveil your newest product, dealing with the calm before the storm, the fact that we've got a couple little nuggets of video talking about the posterizer animations, the fact that we getting some of those dunk animations, the fact that we're getting all that in May, when, like I said, usually we don't see videos like that until late June, and we don't start hearing news until late July. So every year it's always a new year, and I think 2K probably want to get a jump on it as quick as possible, because there could be other reasons why they want to get that jump on it. They could be wanting to jump on it early so that way maybe they can actually do what the community has asked for the past couple years, and that is beta test the game in waves and formats. That's something that EA did do. That's another thing. EA won't really have that heavy of a presence there. They're still going to do EA Play on Saturday, but because they won't have that heavy of a presence as they normally do, One of the things that 2K can take advantage of is, you know, we already know that they're beating NBA Live in the sales numbers, but they can kind of solidify it even more. You give EA a chance to jump out there and showcase what they got. We most likely might see an NBA Live. We most likely might see an NBA Live 20 reveal that is going to, you know, kind of like shake the foundation a little bit. Not, you know, really rock it, but shake it enough. And then 2K fires back. I think these two companies, I kid you not, do you ask me my personal opinion, I think they work together for real, like they coincide with one another. And so like you look at the fact that NBA Live added women and NBA Live 18, and then added custom characters that were females. You can create your own female in NBA Live 19. And 2K said, now we're going to let y'all have that for right now, man. We're going to let y'all rock that. And then we're going to jump on it after y'all done got y'all footing and figured out all the problems. And we're going to spend some time working on it here, working on it there. So we could see some big reveals come out of 2K camp and NBA 2K's camp going into E3. I would not be surprised about it. And if I'm right, I would love to be right about that one. But that's my opinion on Take-Two's expanding their E3 presence going into this year. We'll find out. We got a couple weeks left before E3. About 3 weeks left before E3 takes us all by storm, dropping all these gems, dropping all these games that are gonna come out, man. It's a couple of them I'm looking forward to. Splinter Cell, you know, I'm not saying I'm gonna confirm a Splinter Cell. I'm just saying I would love to see a Splinter Cell. You know, the return of Sam Fisher, man. I need to be on my silent kill thing. But that's my take on the whole 2K at E3. What's yours? Do you think that they're going to show up? Is there a chance? Would you like to see them show up? I would love to see them, but would you like to see them show up? Do you think they're going to show up? What do you think that 2K is going to do at E3? Because they're going to be there. We know that for a fact. This is your boy, Ju King the Boss. As I've been saying, I have been dropping some no commentary playthroughs. It's not because I'm changing the channel up, but I'm adding more content more consistently. The different games that I play, that I just kind of want to share with you guys. I'm working on a few projects in the background as well. So once I'm ready to reveal that information, I'm going to keep you guys in tune and drop a video on that. But it's your boy, Ju King the Boss, man. I'm hoping y'all enjoying the content, man. I catch y'all guys on the next one. Peace.